fabulous breath. Not a move out of place. This is the year you win it all, darling.
Oh, thanks, sweetheart.
You know, if your dad was with us, he'd be really proud seeing his little girl win this race. Hey, it's the 30th annual spring blast.
Well, he always said you made me a better skier.
And I think better person.
But we'll have lots of friends at our wedding. Almost all the invitations have finally come back.
And to the top of the jump once again, and we have Francis Grant set to go. This kid is poised to be one of the big birds of this sport. A kid who can really
flaps
fly.
Up.
He's on the ramp.
It's tight.
He's ready for this one.
Ready for takeoff.
And
and the crowd is screaming, we love you, Tannenberg. He's not just the maintenance man, he's the feel-good skier of the 90s.
I could have made that before the accident. Ouch. With the cliffs there anyway.
And a great takeoff.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, this kid is something else.
A grandmother's cleavage. Twisty nippies. And Jonathan Frosting. Oh. Weak teeth caused that fall. Calcium deficiency. Needed to have center gravity right up. Oh, Tannenberg, that feels so good. Yes, doesn't it? Oh, let me take my top off, Tannenberg. Yes, and call your sister. Oh, yeah. Oh. I feel your pain. Remember, pain is temporary. Glory lasts forever. Fun. Jeez, I forgot this one. I'm a bad boy.
No money, eating out of cans. Make my home in the back of my van. White powder is all that I need. I love the thrill I get from downhill ski.
Yeah!
Ski farm!
Head up to Aspen.
Hit the Rockies for some snow-covered action. Hey, guys! By Jesus, if I'm gonna go to heaven, thank God. Got one life, so live it right. Late to bed, early to rise. Girls can't get enough of those.
What? What?
Shh. Who? No. With you, the clock. Goodbye. God. Good morning, Dave Marshak begins another day. Thank you.
Hey, little fish. Good morning. Gotta get the maid here. Bill. My girl, Bill.
This is not a bill. Mr. and Mrs. Remington Longwood invite you to the wedding of their son, Stephen, to Beth Roberts.
Thank you.
That was a year ago. I've been a walking fungus ever since. It's a wedding. It's just a wedding. It's a great place to meet chicks, free food. She'll look nice in a wedding dress. Hey! Hey, we're here. We're here, Mr. Truck. And, no, this is not good. This, come on, baby. Come on. There's just a few more hills. Okay, oil. What about it? Okay, what I, no. Hi, you got a bus engine? You wanna give me a ride? You don't. Uh-huh.
Alex. Hi, Alex. Alex.
Oh, hi, Dave.
Who is Steve Longwood?
He's the head ski instructor.
He got my job? Why didn't they promote you?
Look at me, Dave.
Okay, you've got a point. Come on, get yourself together. Let's get out of here.
Okay, 2 seconds.
Alex, I don't think you've got any jelly left.
Name?
Lola Schnitzelbank.
Listen, I'm really sorry, Miss Schnitzel. Your name's not on this list.
Well, maybe you could juggle a few balls and put me in as a last minute entry.
I'll,
excuse me, miss. Don't take this the wrong way, but there is something metallic strapped to your back.
It's an easel. I'm a nude painter.
Bet you are, you little vixen.
Steve, you told the last person the entries were closed and to take a hike.
Oh, hey,
shut up. Shh.
Steve Longwood?
Yeah.
We're from the Old Boyfriend Society, a watchdog group for grooms-to-be. Now, according to our records, prior to her engagement to you, Beth Roberts was involved with a handsome, witty, fun-loving guy who pretty much fulfilled all of her needs. So if you'll just sign this form, our records will show that you're no longer interested in marrying Beth, and we'll just get on out of here.
Hey, nice try, fella. Hey, wait a minute. I remember you. Yeah, you're David Marshak. You used to be top dog around here until I took your place. What was it, Dave? Oh. You broke too many rules, and Beth's dad had you thrown off the mountain. And then Beth broke up with you. Oh, gee, Dave. Tough breaks all around, I guess. Should have known you'd be hanging around with the likes of him. Hey, just watch your step.
So speaking of Miss Roberts, where is she these days?
She's right over there.
She happens to manage this mountain now.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I happen to be at this mountain. And you know, Steve, there's an old saying where I come from.
Oh, really?
Que no te encuentren inflando a pelo plano.
What's that supposed to mean?
Don't get caught pumping up a flat dog. Doy. You didn't know what that meant.
Alex, my men! Hey! Yes, I'm back again. So, still taking ski school?
Yeah, beginner's level, year 5.
Good, right. See ya. Whoa, Dave, you are not gonna believe Beth, man. Boy, has she changed. You know, I wish you luck, right? Because Lord knows, I know how hard it is to hang on to a good woman nowadays. Excuse me.
Chili.
Right.
Yeah.
Check you later.
Bye. Excuse me, miss. Oh, my God. This is freaking me out. You look exactly like my ex-girlfriend, but it couldn't be you because she would never marry a guy like Steve Longwood. She was wild. She was vivacious. She wore these black garters.
I think I'll leave you two alone.
My good man, Alex, you don't spend too much time with him, do you?
Well, thank you for asking, Dave. I'm fine. And you? Well, I'm very glad you could make it, since I had no idea what became of you, and I never got back your invitation, and it is 3 days before the wedding.
Better late than never.
Dave, look, I'm very busy. My father left the mountain to me.
Yeah.
I've got a lot of responsibilities now.
I was very sorry to hear about your father. You know, when I knew him, he was always alive.
Look, I know you two didn't always get along.
No, Beth, North and South Korea didn't get along. Your father couldn't stand me.
Come on, you were too wild, Dave. What about the time that you switched my father's cereal with a box of tampons because you thought he needed more fiber in his diet?
Well, he did.
Oh, please. He wasn't the only reason we broke up. You seem to be forgetting the fact that you couldn't make a commitment.
Commitment? Beth, come on, you know that's not my style. Anyway, does that mean you go off and you marry Heinrich von Schmuck?
Steve's a good guy, Dave. Well, he's stable and reliable, handsome, and willing to make a commitment.
But can he tie a cherry stem in a knot with his tongue? Huh?
You know, that's just it. You know, things have changed. I've changed.
Okay, so you're not wearing the same outfit. Big deal. This one's fine.
Look, I have to see to these other people, okay? We'll talk later.
Do you believe that? Commitment, responsibility? Well, I guess I should be thankful you don't have this effect on me.
Hi, Dodibert.
Hi, Dave.
Well, it's nice to see that some people haven't changed around here.
I'm 3 inches shorter.
So what's with the bat-like position?
Well, Dave, I tried a variation on the Pilates certain death flip.
Ah, a variation.
Yes, Dave. With the Pilates, you have to use a variation.
Why is that again?
He died. Anyway, this Steve guy snapped up Beth quicker than you can say Tian Guleao.
The turtles, they're crying.
In Mandarin Chinese.
Well, it isn't Tweedledee.
Hello, Alice.
Saw you talking to Beth today.
Well, it just so happened I was selling her a set of steak knives just to help your married life sparkle. There, now, don't you feel sheepish? I am sorry I shouldn't mention sheep around you.
Sorry, Mr. Bigwood.
Now, you listen to me and you listen good, pal. I don't like you. I've never liked you. In fact, if it wasn't for Beth, I'd
have had a sex change long ago.
But I'm gonna throw off this mountain.
Throw off the mountain?
Okay. All right. Okay, buddy. All right. All right. Your brother refills cream donuts. I'm an only child. Your grandmother sold. She farts dust. I never knew my grandmother. Your father should have pulled out early.
Huh? Huh?
He did.
Your mother...
Won't you ever talk about my mommy... mother?
Top of the morning, Miss Roberts.
Hello, Todderberg. Steve, honey, I see you and Dave have met.
Yeah, we were just talking about our families.
Yeah, well, I have a ski class to teach. Coming, Beth?
Not much with you.
Excuse me, I beg your pardon?
Such a view.
Well, I'm glad you two had a chance to meet. See you around, Dave.
Well, now I know what she sees in the guy.
Friendly.
Right. Your turn.
Me? What?
You do what I just did. Well, look, it's easy. You just gotta have the stomach for it.
No, thanks, man.
Come on.
No takers here. No.
Come on, you can do it. Come on.
No.
Come on. No. Oh, you can do this.
Steve, no, this is a beginner's class, man. I'm just a beginner.
You can do this.
Shouldn't we do this with Annette?
Piece of cake. Yeah, cake is good.
This is gonna be a scream.
Steve, you know, it looks kind of dangerous.
Hey, shut up, will you, Lee?
Come on, chicken. Ah! 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 Ah!
Thanks!
Hey, whoa! Go, man! Get away, pal!
Nice try, but you'll be repeating again.
Steve and I, we have really bonded. We're like this. I mean it. It's amazing.
Well, good. I'm glad to hear it.
Well, I was thinking that later on, all three of us could get together, have a drink. I was thinking about maybe O'Dougal's.
O'Dougal's? Dave, I'm not sure O'Dougal's is how you remember it.
How different could it be?
This is great!
Dave?
Yeah?
I don't seem to be having any effect on the ladies here.
Nope.
Logjam!
Logtastic.
Yeah, where's the men's room?
The men's room?
The men's room.
Right this way. I'll show you the men's room.
Hey, I can squat.
We'd like to suggest holding it in.
Yeah, push it back in.
Both very workable suggestions.
Stewardess?
What did you say?
Can we see menu?
A menu?
Okay, what are the specials? This place came very highly recommended in that little guide they gave me at the rent-a-car place.
It's not a good idea, all right? Please? Come on, let's go. Come on.
No. Come on. It's gonna be fun.
Steve-a-Reno. I heard this was your hangout. Wild man.
What can I get you?
I'll have a vodka tonic. Thank you.
Don't mention it.
Let's move it out
here. I'm going!
Yeah, so I shouldn't have tossed my recyclables into the regular trash.
Man. Resort Town's really cracked down.
Shiva's gone. That's the third one this week!
Sex on the beach.
One sex on the beach. Coming up. Get the hell out of here with that sex on the beach.
Slow, comfortable screw up against the wall.
One slow, long, comfortable screw up against the ball.
I'll have a screaming orgasm.
Ah!
everyone out of here.
Yes, little lady, what can I do for you?
Oh, I don't know. How about a bite me, damn it?
Bite me, damn it. Come on out.
Okay, I think that's just about enough, sweetheart.
Come on, this is fun.
Honey, come on. We've got a wedding rehearsal luncheon that we're expected at tomorrow.
Bye, Dave.
Aren't you gonna stay and try my drink?
That's okay, Dave.
Him taken for a very long ride. Are you listening to me? I want him off my mountain.
Na-na-na-na-na-na. This one is good. Yes.
That helps. Can't hear a thing. Can't hear a thing. Don't want to hear a thing. Daddy, that's an exit. Of our tram, you'll notice the set from the 1937 cult classic Killer Librarians from Crafttown. This, of course, was later remade by Hollywood and became the cult classic E.T. Just up ahead, you'll see the Chasm of Death. Here's a wonderful film
Dave buys the farm.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
A warm welcome to all of you here for the 30th annual Spring Blast. And what would the Spring Blast be without the traditional splash cup? Let's have a big hand for our contestants. They're really making a splash out. And don't forget, there's a special prize today for the most original dash into the drink.
What the heck?
Up at the top of the in run, now we've got, I'm not sure what it is. Hey, check it out. It's a bed of
Oh, yeah, splash cup! Splash cup! Splash cup, daddy! Splash cup!
Yes! Here it is.
Ah, the
Spring Blast. What a blast!
Adrian! Adrian!
The 30th annual Spring Blast continues with the preliminary heats of the mogul competition. Traditional favorite event here at the Spring Blast. We've seen some super performances from the men so far, and it's expected the mogul event has been a real crowd pleaser. Remember, it's a combination of best time and best performance, especially in the aerials, that will determine the winner. The bigger the air, the better you fare here at the Spring Blast. And let's go up to the top of our course now for the start of the women's competition. First up, we have a preliminary heat between newcomer Lola Schnitzelbank, dark horse in this event, and our own Beth Roberts.
Remember what we talked about. Precision. Okay? Keep it crisp. Keep it tight.
Okay. Did I mention fiance?
No flashy stuff, right?
Yes, they've chosen the Spring Blast week in dual slalom down the aisle. Now let's see if love and Steve's coaching has any effect on Beth's command of the mogul course.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Lola Schnitzelbach is the clear winner of this one, but who knows? These two gals could wind up in the finals against each other tomorrow, which just happens to be Beth Roberts and Steve Longwood's wedding day. These two lovebirds may have more than skiing on their mind. Now let's go back up to the top of the course for our next matchup. Here's a couple of fine young competitors just approaching the gate.
Margaret!
Joyce.
No, Dave. Dave Marshak. Me and my friends here stuffed the sausages for today's event.
I don't have you down here. Yet. Well, if you stuffed the sausages.
We stuffed them.
Full and true.
My name's Alex.
Oh, Hacker's here. Let me make you up some name tags. And take a program, too. So what's your name?
Todd or Bert Kaczynski.
Todd or Bert?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, where did you get a name like that?
Well, when I was born, Papa didn't speak much English. He told the doctors that I should be called Todd or Bert. You know, but in those days, he spoke real fast. Doddard, Doddard, Dover, Doddard, Doddard, Doddard! Faster, that hurts!
Aren't you glad you asked?
Oh, and that's Kaczynski. Like the cheese.
Excuse me.
I don't recall inviting you.
No, no, you did. It was right after we pricked our fingers and promised to become blood brothers. You know, I'm sorry I'm late. I had a really rocky sleep last night. Thing is going bump in the night, slipping, sliding. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about.
No, actually, I slept like a log.
Hi.
Hi. Well, look who's here.
Sweetheart, they're not in the wedding party.
Oh, I know, but he came this far and he got all dressed up, which is rare for him.
I also, Miss Roberts.
So I see.
Look, this is strictly not...
I'm sure it'll be okay. As long as you boys behave yourselves.
Oh, we'll behave ourselves. See, Steve, everything's gonna be just peachy.
And I'll look good.
So, they gave me some tests a few years ago. Not so much electricity this time. Call me.
And the wife turns to me and says, here comes the good part. Leonard, the dessert fort is the bigger one.
Oh, I get it.
I haven't said a word yet.
Tell me again.
I haven't said a word yet.
Oh, shut up. You talk too much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Longwood and his lovely fiancée, Bill Roberts, would like to welcome you to their rehearsal luncheon. They are delighted to see so many friends from here and out of town for tomorrow's wedding, and they wish you all a wonderful afternoon. Please draw your attention to the dance floor as our happy couple gets the dancing started here this afternoon.
Jump! You have so much to live for!
Did it work? I gave them proper instructions, but they panicked.
Steve, there's a phone call for you.
Yeah, in a minute.
The guy says it's important.
I'll be right back.
Hello, babe.
Hello, Steve Longwood. Who is this?
This is Rear Admiral Expector with the Volunteer Fire Department now.
Don't panic, but... Here's me and the boys can tell. You got a code Zebra 09er ripping through your sunroom. I don't have a sunroom.
Will you get your head together, man? Don't make me come through this phone and slap some man into you. Now listen up.
What exactly is a code 0 Zebra 9er?
Are you ready, animal?
And you were playing Fort. You remember that?
You were out in your grassy knoll playing Fort with your cardboard box
and a big bag of fried flour, and you had nothing to worry about in the world. You had not a care at all. All right. And the big fat kid from across the way would come. Hey, thank you. Remember, children under six enjoy complimentary chicken thighs. That kid was enormous. He must have weighed 260 pounds in the sixth grade. And he'd just be sitting there, not bothering anybody, and he'd... Why, yes, sir. In fact, I'll personally come up and give you a cream massage.
Sorry, Mr. Lungfish.
It's long with you, Cassette, and what the hell is going on here?
Music.
This is not in the program. Davey, Davey, Davey. You know I could have you arrested.
I'd have my own cell in the joint.
Look, you listen to me. I'm marrying Beth, and there's not a damn thing you can do about it. And not only that, your little freak friend here is going to be building snow forts to live in once I give him the boot.
I don't think you have that authority, Fräulein.
You know something, Davey? You're right. I don't. Not yet. Get him out of here.
Come on!
No, 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 not him. Please, not him. Oh, dear God. Not my joy boy.
You're working on that zany, carefree style of yours.
Who asked you?
Just trying to be supportive.
Yeah, right. Just like your shenanigans on the dance floor. You're out of control, Dave.
So, how long has it been since you've done that?
Come on, I still do that.
Yeah, not that I've seen. I mean, I'm sure you can probably do it if you say you can, but if you can't, yeah, I understand.
Wuss, 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 wuss.
fun. We can have fun. Remember the time we went heli-skiing and got lost? Had to spend the night on the mountain?
Yeah, it was cold.
It was cozy.
Yeah. We never did ski Death Row together.
We will. Someday.
I'll see you later, Dave.
He's just not for you.
I'd say that's looking pretty good. Listen, I don't think you need a brush-up lesson, but, you know, that's why I'm here. That's what you paid me for.
Did you say brush-up? Do you remember when you last saw me with a brush?
Yeah, listen, if you're referring to that little incident yesterday, I really wouldn't want you to misunderstand.
Maybe I could give you a few lessons.
I like your face enough to sit
for a portrait. See you later, Steve.
What's her story?
Huh? Oh, nothing. Nothing. Hey, nothing.
Steve.
Yeah?
You don't think I've become boring or anything? I'm fun, aren't I?
Of course you are, darling. You think if you weren't fun, you could have snagged a guy like me? Huh? Come here. That's my girl. Oh, yes. I love you. I love you. Yes.
I just want to tell you kids what a cute couple you make. Oh, Steve. I'm so sorry. I thought that was Lola.
You told me to take him for a long ride off the mountain.
Oh, never mind, you little twerp. Did you know that little creep was with my Beth all afternoon?
Yeah, but weren't you with that Lola woman?
Would you shut up? What does that have to do with anything?
Nothing, I guess.
Yeah, well, you guessed right. Oh, jeez, there's that little no mind. God, I hate
he's been here so long.
Hey, Beth's dad and I had an arrangement. Beth doesn't know about it. Got the old man to sign a deal just before he kicked. Says that if I marry Beth, I get control of the entire mountain.
That's a pretty lot.
Yeah, damn straight. Hey.
Yeah. Alex? Alex, Alex. Don't die on me, man. Can it be true if you really been boffed to death?
Don't do that to me, man. Well, now, isn't this cozy and convenient?
Steve, that NAMBLA meeting let out early?
Look, Dave, this is the last time I'm gonna warn you. Quit screwing up our wedding plans.
Now, Steve, I know that the feelings you have for me are confusing you. That's natural.
Oh. Look, Dave, it's been real. But all good things must come to an end.
Hi, fellas. You must be looking for the donkey rides. Well, apparently they left town as soon as they heard you were arriving. So. Oh, boy. Boy.
Dave Matt. What the hell happened to you?
I kept myself shaving.
Guess what I just found out?
What?
Steve conned Beth's old man. The only reason he's marrying Beth is so he can take over the mountain.
That doink. If they're getting married tomorrow, we gotta do something.
Beth's at her bachelorette party tonight. and Steve will be off at his.
Perfect.
Listen, you concentrate on Beth. Don't worry about Steve. He'll have his hands full.
All right. Well, hello, Mr. Rip Van Winkle. Okay, women, hide Alex. Oh!
Ladies. Okay.
Hey, what are you guys doing?
Look.
Those are great. I mean, this is great. Yes. I'd like to ask for your help. You see, a few of the guys, you know, we're gonna get together, crash a party. Steve!
Why didn't you say so? But there is something you can do for me.
Name it.
Hello, Studleys? Yes, you had a strippogram scheduled for Beth Roberts' bachelorette party later this evening? Yes, well, there's been a change in venue. Could you please send your steaming hunk of man to O'Dougal's bar in town? That's right, O'Dougal's. I know that. That would be very sweet. You're very sweet. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Ooh, my. What a fetching ensemble.
Well,
what?
Try it on.
No.
Oh, come on. Put it on.
You think so?
Yeah. Sure.
All right. I'll be right back.
God, when is that stripper getting here?
My special buddy.
Hey, listen. Now you don't forget. Take that special delivery letter over to that idiot Handyman's cabin. Hmm?
Hey!
Sure. I'll do it tonight. Oh, hey. This time tomorrow. All this scum will be off now. All I gotta do is marry old Beth. Is it lust? Is it love? Push comes to shove. It's tough love. It's tough love. With Luke Jack and Kill.
Yeah!
some room in here. Give me the camera. This is perfect. Okay. Come on, let's go, let's go, let's go. Give me the camera. Keys. Okay. Look, hold on. Just don't press this button. Yeah, 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 yeah. Because this is already set and the lens is new.
Want a number to make a date with Jesus, maybe. She's so suggestive. You in a trance. You're breathing heavy with a surprise in your pants. Can you ever get enough?
She's gonna get his pants off. Whoa, she's taking. Yes, yes, yes. Hold on, just let me see.
Is it lust? Is it love? When push comes to shove, it's time.
She's struggling. Oh my! She's struggling.
Come on, Beth.
I'm coming.
That's what you'll be saying tomorrow night.
That's not what I heard.
I know, me too. You know, they haven't even done it. You guys.
We're supposed to be showing our support.
Oh, if you wanted her to have support, you wouldn't have bought her that teddy.
Woo!
Tell the truth, Beth. Could you get Steve hot like that?
Of course.
Oh, sure.
So our relationship is just a little more, conventional. So there's more to getting married than...
Oh, cut the analytical crap. Where's the damn stripper?
Are you ready to make art history?
Sorry. Oh God, she's painting their bodies.
She's what?
She's painting their bodies. Thank us. Beth gets a little shot. She's going to dump this guy for sure. Oh, God, I think they're going to do it.
Do what?
Do it. Do what?
Oh, yeah.
Get out of the way! Get out of the way!
That it was just gonna be us. I mean, we're getting married tomorrow. I don't want him to get mad. I mean, what am I gonna tell him that we were doing tonight?
He's here!
Yeah.
Well, it's a tough job. Somebody's got to do it.
Oh, I think I just might remember what I saw of you.
Well, let's hit the trail, babe. Come on.
So, Beth, so you're not gonna marry Steve tomorrow, eh, Nillian?
Yes. No, Dave, I am marrying Steve. D4.
Miss. Okay. What about this? What if this Steve guy is an alien and he's replaced you with someone else? D9.
Miss. Dave, I'm pretty sure I know what I'm doing here. E9.
Miss? Listen, Beth, I'm not asking you to give up much, just your plans for Saturday and every Saturday after that. F9.
Hit. So you're saying that you're ready to make K? F7.
Hit. Yes, I'm ready with the car to pick you up at A7.
Miss. All right. Yes, lately I've been confused.
Beth, you should be confused. Listen, I gotta tell you something. The only reason this Steve guy is marrying you is so he can...
He managed to gurgle enough to tell me he's going to be marrying you in the morning.
Is that my battleship?
You mean, you did this?
I told him, watch his zany, unpredictable side. But did he listen? No, he didn't listen.
No, Dave, you're the one who has to listen. Look at him.
Well, I've always been a big fan of his wardrobe.
Oh, shut up.
Listen, I don't think you'd be so upset if you knew that your fashion plate fiancé here was marrying you just so he
could. That's enough, okay? He could have got pneumonia out there. Look, my fiancé needs my help right now. Just get out. It would make me very happy if I never had to see you again. Oh, and as far as the wedding is concerned, consider yourself uninvited.
So you want me to leave?
Women, huh?
Election notice. Steve Longwood, president.
How long have I been asleep? You there! What year is it?
Oh. Welcome to our final day of racing here at the 30th annual Spring Blast. It's been a great week of spring skiing here, and we're going to wrap things up with a classic confrontation in the women's mogul final. The blue course, the top corner.
Break a leg.
Lola Schnitzelbach.
You too.
List her hobbies as cultural.
Your, you got to face Alma's husband looked quite a sight last night.
The event that her father started 30 years ago.
What do you know about it? Honey, I was the one that got him halfway there. The naked panda part, anyways. Screw this precision crap. I'm going back to Beth basics.
Hey, nothing happened.
Prepare to lose.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Out of the gate, the racers are putting all they've got into the bump. It's a tough, demanding event. And right now, Beth Roberts is showing some aggressiveness that we didn't see yesterday. Something's under her skin because she's really pounding those bumps. They're very close going into the first aerial, and that's a beautiful spread eagle by Beth. Ola is just a little behind, and she displays her reliable style. A perfect landing, and these two racers are neck and neck. It may come down to the best performance on the next aerial, but Beth Roberts has been conservative so far this week. Let's see what she can muster here. A 360! Beth Roberts has pulled off a perfect 360, and Lola can't match it. Beth is now well ahead in style points, and she'll cross the finish line and a clear winner here at the Spring Glass. Ladies and gentlemen, our own Beth Roberts is the women's mogul champion here at the 30th annual Spring Glass. No doubt her coach, Steve Longwood, deserves much of the credit.
What's with those moves, honey? That's not what we worked out.
Don't talk to me about working things out.
What?
Hey, I said nothing happened. We didn't do anything. Not that I didn't try.
Nice try, Lola. I mean, I figured you to be a sore loser. Don't you think it's kind of rude to take me down with you? Hey, what the heck, honey? You're one place going.
Personally, I don't think the wimp's worth it. She's way too good for you, Chisel Chest.
Once again for the new women's mogul champion and her soon-to-be husband, our very own ski school director, Steve Longwood. Let's hear it for Beth and Steve. Let's hear it for Ski School!
Let's rock.
This was Dad's favorite hat. Those irregular moments.
Todibert, what are you gonna do?
I don't know. You know me, I land on my feet like a dog. I'll sleep with older women for appliances or maybe open up that 8-track repair store.
I can't believe this. I'm so depressed. I even got a good night's sleep, if you know what I mean.
Hey, guys. What gives?
What, are you kidding?
No, I'm not kidding. So Beth's getting married. Big deal. Look at you all, feeling sorry for yourselves. Todibert, you think you're getting kicked off this mountain? Alex, look at you, all rested and refreshed. It's pitiful. And Tomcat, you're thinking, there goes beginner's level, year 6. Well, frankly, I think, guys, that we're better than that.
You know, Dave, I wish you'd just lay off. Just get off our backs! Yeah, we blew it. We didn't get your pictures.
We didn't get the pictures. We didn't get you. We didn't get your birth. Let me see the pictures. Let me see the pictures!
Dave.
Oh. We can work with these.
Dave, the girl's getting married in 3 hours. Give it up. It's over. It's done. Stick a fork in it.
Stick a fork in it. Stick a fork in it. Did Columbus stick a fork in the Nina, the Santa Maria, and whatever that third ship was?
The Pinata?
Did the astronauts stick a fork on the moon?
I believe it was Uranus.
Like Steve Longwood, tell us what to do.
No.
Let me hear you.
No.
And are we gonna let you lose the only job that you were even remotely qualified for?
No!
And am I gonna show Beth Roberts that I am the man she needs?
No!
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 What?
Yes.
Well,
you know, you had us going the one way, and then you...
Anyway, what are we gonna do to Steve Longwood?
We're gonna pummel!
Yeah!
We'll make mincemeat out of him.
Yeah!
I'll take a needle-nose pliers, grab his uvula, pull it out of his mouth, staple gun it to a 2x4, and he's a human paddleball game!
Okay, we're gonna remember that. If we use it, you'll get full credit. Now, let's...
go!
What do you say we go to this wedding in style in my brand new cherry red Beamer?
Yeah, but Steve, how could you afford a car like that?
Went and borrowed the money. Why not? 3 hours, the mountain, Beth, all of her assets are going to be mine. Matt reminds me, make sure that you get that eviction notice up immediately after the wedding. Man, I'd love to see that face.
But, Steve, I already...
Stop! Oh, come on, I'm late for my damn wedding!
I'm glad you could make it.
Don't start with me, Beth. Please, do not start. Get in there. Look, sweetie, let's just get through this, okay?
Dearly beloved, we gather today to join Stephen with Beth in the bonds of matrimony so that they may know how much all of us here honor their union. I ask all of you to read aloud with me an inspirational passage from page 6 in your program. We all know that the path of righteousness is fraught with temptations.
grinning minions of the devil himself. There are beasts with the heads of men. But we dare not succumb to fleshy pleasures. For we know that a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush. I can see that you don't wish to read with me, so I'll just press on. I would now ask that the symbols of this great union, the rings, be brought forth.
Think you're doing, you idiot.
I am the ringmaster.
Before Stephen and Beth exchange vows today, a good friend of theirs would like to commemorate their union with a song, a very special song. Joyce?
Wedding bells ringing, new lovers grow. Oh, new lovers growing, bird ready and perky. My breasts are heaving. I'm not wearing any underwear, 'cause I find them confining. That'll ring you.
I where were we?
Come on.
If there is anyone present here who objects to this union, then let him come forward now, speak his piece, or be forever silent.
Stop!
You wish to speak your piece?
No.
So then no one else here objects to this union?
Ah!
No, not me.
Very well. Let us proceed with the vows.
Now wait just one gosh darn minute.
Who's that?
It's me, you fool, the man upstairs. And I am pissed off.
So am I. That's it.
Beth Roberts, please step forward. So what's the deal here, Beth? You seem to have plumb forgotten what a great thing you had going with the Dave man.
All right, Marshak, knock it off!
It is Steve, the man who, unbeknownst to Beth, made a deal with her father so he could gain control of the mountain and then banish her friends from the mountaintop forevermore. And the guy who will doom Beth to an eternal blazing barefoot and pregnant hell. I mean, heck. Hey. Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain.
Go ahead, Beth, ask him.
Sweetheart, you're not gonna listen to these idiots.
Look what they've done to our wedding.
Cupcake. Our friends.
Get out.
Honey, control yourself.
No, control this!
If your daddy could see you now.
Out!
Private lessons.
How's your schedule?
I'm available.